Welcome, everyone. We're here today to talk about Parkinson's disease. With me, I have one of our physicians, and I'll ask him to introduce himself.
My name is Wojtek Gritz. I'm a movement disorders neurologist at Valley Medical Center. Movement disorders neurologist is a type of neurologist who sees patients with a variety of movement problems, including Parkinson's disease, tremors, dystonia, or cerebellar ataxia.
Let's start with our first question. What is Parkinson's disease and what causes it?
Parkinson's disease is a neurological disorder that affects movement. It is due to the loss of nerve cells that are used in production of the chemical messenger called dopamine. Dopamine is very crucial in regulating and controlling movement. We do not know what exactly causes this nerve loss. However, there's a lot of research trying to look into that.
What are the main symptoms of Parkinson's disease, and how can they vary between individuals?
The main symptoms of Parkinson's disease include things like tremors or shaking of part of the body, rigidity or stiffness in the body, bradykinesia or slowing of the body, postural instability or gait issues, and balance problems. Individuals can vary greatly in terms of what symptoms they have developed. For example, some people may have their primary symptoms to be tremor or the shaking of the body, while others can have more of a slowness or stiffness. Some people can also progress at different rates and different times, and that can be affected by a variety of factors and medical conditions.
What are the most common misconceptions about Parkinson's disease?
The most common misconception about Parkinson's disease is that it affects older people. While it is more common in patients above age 60, it can still affect younger people. It is rare, but still possible. Therefore, this highlights the importance of early diagnosis and intervention in younger population. Another common misconception that I run into is that Parkinson's disease is inherited or genetic disorder. While there are rare cases of genetic forms of Parkinson's disease, and there is research that's trying to understand the interplay between genetic and environmental factor, vast majority of patients with Parkinson's disease are sporadic, or meaning that the disorder develops by chance. What this means is that just because a person has Parkinson's disease doesn't mean that their children or family member will develop it. Another common misconception that I run into with patients with Parkinson's disease is that it only affects physical symptoms. While those symptoms are the most visible, for example, tremor and stiffness, a lot of patients with Parkinson's disease also have non-motor symptoms. For example, gastrointestinal issues, anxiety, depression, sleep disturbance, or cognitive changes. That is why it's important to focus on those other symptoms as they can also affect their life significantly. Therefore, a holistic approach is very important in the management of Parkinson's disease.
How is Parkinson's disease diagnosed? Are there specific tests or assessments used?
There is no specific test for Parkinson's disease. The diagnosis usually involves thorough medical evaluation, review of systems, and in-depth neurological examination. In some cases, doctors may use Parkinson's disease medications to help rule in or rule out Parkinson's disease. And in some cases, they may employ blood work, imaging tests, or even skin biopsies.
What are the current treatment options for Parkinson's disease?
Treatment for Parkinson's disease currently focuses mainly on symptom management, as unfortunately there is no cure. Medications work by improving symptoms by either replenishing or mimicking the effects of the dopamine. Physical therapy and exercise is very important for balance and mobility. In some cases, even surgical options, for example, deep brain stimulation or DBS, can be used. All of the above strategies are extremely important to improve the functioning and quality of life for patients.
What advances in treatment have been made in recent years?
Recent advancements in treatment of Parkinson's disease include new medications that are able to control the symptoms for a longer period of time and decrease the side effects. New surgical options and implantable devices have been used to improve the functioning, the effectiveness of the medication, and to increase the independence of people with Parkinson's disease. Research into medications affecting the disease progression, gene therapy, and stem cell is very active and is currently ongoing. There's also been focus on a holistic approach and tailored treatment for each patient, therefore focusing on their personal needs and condition.
What factors contribute to a better quality of life for patients with Parkinson's disease?
A multidisciplinary approach to treatment of Parkinson's disease patients is very important, involving neurologists, physical therapists, occupational therapists, and even mental health providers can enhance the well-being of patients. Physical exercise, well-balanced diet, and social engagement are also very important. Staying active with support groups, family members, and friends can also improve the functioning and well-being of patients.
If you or your loved one has symptoms, what should you do next?
If you or your loved one are experiencing symptoms that you are concerned may be due to Parkinson's disease, for example, tremor or shaking of a part of your body, stiffness on one side of the body, slowing of movement or balance problems, the first step will be to consult with your primary care provider. They can provide your initial assessment and refer you to a neurologist who specializes in movement disorders to provide further diagnosis and management. It is important to get their interventions early as they can provide with better management of symptoms and long-term benefits.
Thank you for answering our questions today, Dr. Gritz. And for those of you watching, if you'd like to learn more, please go to our website.